Welcome back to another session of 2017 Vitality World Summit. I'm Steve Prusak. We're so excited about our next guest. It's Dana Wilde. And after growing her business from zero to $1 million a year in under 19 months, she now teaches others how to do the same. With over 100,000 followers in over 68 countries, Dana's the best-selling author of Train Your Brain. She's been featured in movies like The Abundance Factor and Dream Big. Fascinated by neuroscience and the power of the mind, she affects lives daily on the Mind Aware show, where she interviews thought leaders, brain scientists, and celebrities about how to intentionally think wealthier, happier, and healthier thoughts. Let's welcome to the Vitality World Summit, Dana Wilde.
Woot, woot. Hi, Steve. So good to be here.
I love it, Dana. This is our, we've had you on our radio show. It's great to connect with you face-to-face and bring you out on video to our audience. This is awesome.
I love being here. I love everything you do, Steve. I'm so happy to be a part of this.
Oh, same here, Dana. Dana, so when we're talking about vitality and longevity and mindset is always one of the facets of longevity that we talk about, the four, facets of longevity. Talk to us about training your brain for health and how that all ties in.
That's a great question. You know, can I tell you a little story? Recently, my mother-in-law had surgery. She's 90 years old. And as part of the surgery, she ended up in one of these kind of rehabilitation facilities for a short while before she went home. And in the facility, there was this woman, she's 103 years old, and standing completely upright and really, just vitality is the perfect word for her, vibrant, just alert and engaged. And so naturally, when you meet somebody like this, you're like, what's the secret? You know, what's the secret to your longevity? And she said, you have to really want to live to be 103. And I thought, oh my gosh, that is such good advice. Like how, if you have that expectation for yourself, if you're expecting like, okay, I'm going to live to be 103. I want to live to be 103 and be healthy and agile and have a good brain. You are going to be making different decisions today in how you live your life if you have that intention for yourself. And so this is where mindset comes in. You know, it's really in deciding that that's what you want, setting the intention, thinking you can do it, thinking you can achieve it, believing it can happen, intentionally thinking positive thoughts in your head that are going to get you there. And then ultimately, you start taking the actions, and we can talk about the reticular activating system because that's really what goes to work for you, and you can start taking the actions that get you there.
Yeah, let's definitely dive into that. But first, you know, for you, for those that are new to your work, share how you got into this, how you started implementing this, and what it did for your own life.
Yeah, I first learned about brain training way back in the day when I was working in a corporate office in one of these cubicle jobs. And I ended up immediately, was put through a 40-hour training on the brain. And once I figured out that your brain creates your outcomes, I thought, oh my gosh, I'm so out of this cubicle job. And bless their hearts, I quit. And I kind of started my own grand adventures. So I lived overseas for like 10 years. I published a book at age 23 and became a published author. I, won Telly Awards in producing. And then finally, I ended up in my business. And in my direct sales business, it was one of those like in-home party plan businesses. And what I realized was everybody in the world is teaching how to is the method to success. And so I said, why isn't anybody talking about the brain? This is like the thing. Mindset's the thing to make you successful, for, business, financially. So I trained my team and we went from zero to $1 million in 19 months, which shattered the company record. Eventually sold that business and I founded the Mind Aware, and we not only replicated the success there, but now we teach others how to do that too, because this is stuff that's really easy to teach. If you're willing to open your mind and try some things that sound a little crazy, it's really easy to use these principles for yourself.
I love the way it applies to wealth and health and everything in life. And is that the truth? I mean, it really could apply to anything, we can create our life as we want it.
Yes, yes, it is the truth. It's exactly true. What we're talking about, Steve, we live in a world people care about so many things. They care about the clothes they wear. They care about the car they drive. They care about the food they eat. They care about the school that their kids go to. They care about so many things. Well, I want people to start caring about the thoughts in their head. It's simple as that. Because if you start caring about the thoughts you're thinking, that's going to affect every other area of your life.
So take us back. How do you say that change begins with mindset? How do we get there?
Yeah, good. Thank you for that. Okay. The whole Train Your Brain program is basically four steps. Step one is to become aware. Become aware of what you're thinking. Become aware of your thoughts. So in the health arena, there are thoughts that might be going in the head of like, I've tried this before and I haven't been successful. Or, I hate salad, or, you know, I've never been fit or healthy, and so how can it happen for me now? So self-doubt or things like that, start paying attention to that kind of background noise or even the background feeling of that feeling of, I'm not sure if I can do this, you know? And step two is making a decision. If you want to continue matching that up in your life, everybody has inside of their brain a part of the brain called the reticular activating system. This is like a little matchmaker that lives in your head all day, every day, 24 hours a day, sifts through the monkey muck. Right now, wherever you're sitting, look around you and notice all the colors in your awareness and all the sounds and sensations and all the kind of stimuli that's happening in any given moment. Well, this would like, our brains would overload if we had to process all this. And many of you have probably had the experience of using your reticular activating system without even realizing it. Maybe you have wanted to buy a new car, or you've been thinking about buying a different color car, and then pretty soon it's like everywhere you look, you see that car. Or maybe you're pregnant, or your partner's pregnant, or you want to get pregnant, and suddenly now everywhere you look, there are pregnant women. Mm. Well, this is the reticular activating system. It's whatever you're thinking about, whatever you're talking about, it stands at attention for you all day, every day, and says, this must be important to you, so I got your back. I'm going to match that up. Fantastic if you're thinking thoughts like, I love exercise, right? You know, then your reticular activating system is helping your body get that urge to get up and run around the block, right? But if you have that idea that I can't do this or I can't be successful, then what your reticular activating system is picking up instead of green cars or blue cars, what it's picking up is all sorts of temptations that will take you down the wrong path. So it starts with talking differently in your head. Is that, are you with me so far, Steve?
Yeah, that makes sense. And so one of the things we always have to overcome is whether it be from media or our own family and friends, even our parents could put self-doubt or limiting beliefs, things that may have come up when we were 5 years old, where a teacher might have said something to us that we just sticks with us. Do you have that experience? And how do you work with your clients to overcome that, to change those thought patterns?
Yes, great examples, you know, because it does. We're products of the culture, too. You know, we get a lot of messages from the culture about what we expect for ourselves or kind of what everybody else is doing, all of this type of thing, not to mention commercials and all of the things that come on. So step three in the process is to intentionally think different thoughts, intentionally talk about the current situation in a way that feels good until step four, you can feel positive. So what I tell people is only you can think in your head, and you can have had all the influence of whatever kind of negative influence you had growing up, no matter what's happening. But in this moment right now, only you can think in your head. And there is nothing more important than the power of your focused thought. So you may not be able to go around and say a perfect language mantra like, I'm healthy and fit, I'm healthy and fit, I'm healthy and fit. If you don't see yourself that way, it's going to feel like you're lying to yourself. But you can start to talk about the current situation in a way that feels better. And I can give you some really good mind hacks for that if you want.
Yeah, that would be great.
So one of my favorite mind hacks for that is using the word but. Because the word but negates everything that comes before it. So what if you have an image of yourself as I've never been healthy and fit. I've never been that person who was healthy and fit. I've never been somebody who exercised, or I've never had a habit of eating right. Well, that's okay to say that. admit that. Be honest about that. Be like, you know what? I haven't really had a habit of eating right my whole life. But now you say that word, but what the brain hears is discount everything else that you just said, right? Just ignore that. And what it remembers is what comes after. You know, I've never had a habit of eating right, but I'm getting better now. But things are going my way, but I'm more open than ever. But I met Steve Prusak and he's got me on the right track. But I started this cleanse and with the Juice Guru and it's working out great. But I feel like I'm a new person. I feel like I'm reborn, but I'm open to new ideas. But I feel like I could get better at this, but I'm a different person than I used to be. Right now, feel how good that feels when I say all those buts. And I could just go on and on and on. We could take up the rest of the interview with me just filling up buts for that. But it's a feel good. It doesn't feel good to sit and say, I can't do it. I'm no good. I've never had a history of doing it. Maybe you haven't, but you know what? You've never had all the knowledge that you have now either. And this knowledge, add this to the coffers. Only you can think in your head. Once you start getting that, now you start getting emotional momentum. Once you start saying those phrases, but I'm a new person, but I'm ready, but this is a new time, but I've met the right person to help me through this, but I never knew about juicing before, but now I'm getting better at this. Once you start getting that emotional alignment and that emotional momentum going, now try to hold you back from positive action. You can't stop yourself when you feel that good.
So is it that we typically don't do that? We have the negative talk, maybe even hear it from a friend, but it's not followed by that but, so our brain creates that reality?
Exactly. The brain will match up whatever you're talking about and whatever you're thinking about. And it's not so much, you know, I guess I'll just put it this way. I think sometimes we have a tendency, it's not so much that we're even thinking negatively, it's that we're not thinking intentionally. Mm-hmm. You know, so we're just kind of reacting to situations. So most people's lives, we have a thing, we call it the cycle of perpetual sameness, which I think you'll like. Most people's lives, they have a result. They see the result. They talk about the result. They think about the result. They complain about the result. They talk about the result. They think about the result. Reticular activating system keeps matching up and gives you the result again. Then we talk about it, and then the reticular activating system matches up again. So most people have very incremental change in their lives, because they're just looking at results and talking about results and looking at results and talking. Very few, a small percentage of the world understands that if you start thinking a different thought, you're going to start getting a different result because you're going to create a different emotion. You're going to take different actions. You know, this isn't like sit in a room and meditate and then the universe is going to bring you something. This is about understanding how your brain works and using it better. You know, we want to have healthy hearts. We want to have healthy bodies. Well, this is about starting to understand how your brain works so you're using it to create the outcomes you want.
So how important is it what we feed ourselves, even through media, if we're watching TV and some of the negative news stories and things that could lead to depression, things like that? How do we filter what's going on in the world around us?
I just get rid of it all myself. That's my solution. Talk about a fast. There's a fast, right?
Media fast.
Yeah, just don't. Well, here's the thing. Once you have this awareness, you start getting really picky about what you're willing to put into your brain and what you're willing to match up. So it's not like you walk around just, oh, I'm blissed out all the time and I'm just bouncing off the ceilings happy. You just get to be more discerning. You know, I have habits of thought that I know maybe don't serve me, but I just care, like I don't care about them. Like for a long time, I had a habit of thought that was, I'm not a morning person. Okay, now it would probably be better for me to be a morning person, but I don't care. I can be successful without being a morning person, so I don't do it. So you start getting discerning about what do I want to think in my head? And you start watching a program and you feel your body starting to feel bad. You don't want to accept that anymore. It's funny. It's interesting how similar it is to food, isn't it? And health. Right. You know, it's like you get a habit of the sugar habit and you mm-hmm. think it's feeding something. You think it feels good for a second. And then you start realizing over time that it's not a feel good. You start identifying that, oh, I don't feel good when I eat sugar. You don't want to do it. Well, it's the same thing with the news. You know, you may think you're getting a boost of like, oh, now I'm aware, I'm knowledgeable, or I'm, you know, I'm involved because I feel angry about this situation. But soon you start to realize that it's just a big feel bad and you don't want to be around it anymore. You don't want to have anything to do with it anymore.
I see. That's really interesting. So, for example, if it's our food, we want to change what we're eating or make shifts to that. And there's these emotions tied into it, right? Well, I don't know what part of the brain that is. Where is it the...
like the dopamine and the serotonin that get released, the chemicals, the happy chemicals.
You know where the memories are in the the back of the brain? There's...
Right.
Just forget it. The limbic system.
Yes.
So though we know that it's associated with those past memories and we'll go to that and we'll use food to numb ourselves and things like that, whether it be food or alcohol or anything else that we're doing to escape. What are you saying? Are you saying that we want to reprogram and we can actually live through all these, you know, up and downs in our lives?
Yes. Yes, that's exactly right. You know, for myself, I've been doing this for 30 years, and there doesn't come a point, or there hasn't in my life yet, where negative thinking goes away, right? Every single day, I have something that I get angry about, usually my computer, something that I get angry about, or something that I get frustrated with, or I get overwhelmed with, or I have a negative thought, or I have a moment of self-doubt, or whatever it is. But what happens is we get better at catching it, and we get better at turning it around. So rather than going off, having something that's upsetting happen outside of ourselves and going off for 3 days and stewing about it and talking about it to everybody and recreating it, what happens is you have a bad moment or you have a bad emotion and you catch it and you get aware and you go, okay, this doesn't feel good. And you get to be really snobbish, I guess is the word, where you just almost refuse to be sitting and letting anything take your happiness away. Like, it's just like so much of the stuff that used to bother you, it's just like, I'm just not even going to think about that or deal with that because it doesn't serve me. It's so much easier just to be happy and just to think happy thoughts. And for those people who have had a lifetime of being negative, here's what I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, because we've seen this work in just literally tens of thousands of people. The more negative you are, or the more negative your background is, the faster this works. Because if you think about it, you've been going about your whole life, banging around, getting the results you've been getting with a negative attitude. So when you apply even just a little bit of this, you start to just see incredible results. You know, happy people, people who are naturally positive, we might be able to take their lives from an 8 to a 10, you know, but people who really have had a hard time with negativity, if you're willing to play along and take a shot at this, you know, just take a shot at soothing yourself. I think we like mantras. We like perfect language. It's nice to be able to say, I'm confident, I feel good, I eat well, I treat my body well, I love my body and my body loves me. It's nice to be able to say those things. But if you can't, then talk about it in the best way you can. Think about how you would talk about it to a child or to your best friend. If your child came up to you and said, Mom, I'm fat, you wouldn't say, yeah, you are, you know, too bad. You would say, oh gosh, you know what? You know, you look great and you're getting better all the time and you're learning more about health and you, I love that you're taking an interest in this and love yourself and love your body and it will love you back. You would soothe a child or you'd soothe a friend. Well, we need to start talking to ourselves like that. We need to start soothing ourselves more. We need to start realizing that if we can start soothing ourselves and we can start feeling good, that is the impetus to action. You know, most of the time when people don't make change, it's not that they don't know what to do. They know what to do, but they don't feel like doing it. Or they don't feel like they're going to be successful, or they get defeated right away, or they're trying to force themselves to do things they don't want to do. Well, what we're suggesting is when you talk nicely to yourself, when you get fired up, when you feel good about yourself and about life and the progress you're making and the direction you're headed, you can't help but take good action because you can't wait to do something. You can't wait to dive in. That's the secret sauce to success.
I love that. So is it, how does that look in real time? Is it, are we looking at ourselves in the mirror and repeating these things? Or are we meditating on them when we're going to sleep at night? How do we make it a practice?
That's really a good question, Steve, that you do believe nobody has ever asked me that. That's a really good question. Yeah. So give yourself a pat on the back. You're such a good interviewer. See, that's my good self-talk for you. How do you like that? That's like, you should be saying that in my head. Like, I'm a good interviewer. Okay. So here's the deal. The first thing you can do is try to catch yourself more often. You know, just try to catch yourself more often. When you're having that moment, try to catch yourself. And when you catch yourself, don't say, oh, bad me, I'm thinking negative again. Say, oh, good me, I caught myself again. Right? I just caught myself thinking negative. That's awesome. I'm getting aware. Like, that's the ticket. I called my company the Mind Aware. I didn't call my company the Mind Happy. It's the Mind Aware. We're just getting aware. Okay. So catch yourself as often as you can. Start your day, even while you're in bed, linger for 60 seconds to 120 seconds, making the decision, I'm going to have a good day today. I'm looking forward to today. I've got, here's what's on. I'm so happy to have this other chance. I'm so happy to feel so refreshed. I'm looking forward to this day. Set the intention that you're making a choice to be happy. Because if you do that, you're going to get further and further into your day before somebody knocks you off your center. It's going to really help to have that reserve. Finally, do what you can to set reminders for yourself of the new story. So we tell people, set up a phone reminder, have it go off 5 or 10 times a day, where it just says something like, a positive mantra, you're doing great, now's the time to think positive, tell your new story, right? Something that's like, today's a great day, you know, any kind of happy thing, everything's going my way. Mm. Oh, there's all sorts of little happy phrases you can do. That will remind you that many times to stay centered. And then we ask people to put post-it notes up. Just put them up with your mantras. And you feel silly doing it at first, but you put something up that says, you're awesome. When you see that 8 or 10 times a day in your car, on your fridge, and you start to just, your brain sees it. Even when you quit saying it, you start to think like, okay, I'm awesome. I am awesome. This is great. It's easy. And then finally, one more piece, I guess, since you brought it up about going to bed. When you go to bed at night, you know, set the intention that now I'm going to sleep, I'm going to release everything from the day, and when I wake up in the morning, I'm going to start my day fresh again, and I'm going to feel good. Because just that practice of making it a desire, making it your intention to be aware, to be happy, to be centered, to be present, to be nice to yourself. I mean, all of those things, making that your intention and your desire, to think in your own head. I mean, think of what a huge thing that is, to be able to think in your own head. Well, that's the whole game. That's the whole game. If you have the desire to do it, you already are doing more than 99.99% of the population.
So what about when those negative forces come in? And I mean, there's different levels to those, because it could be, if it's someone you don't know, it's not going to really affect you, especially if you're in the right mindset. But if it's someone, a parent or a partner or someone that's bringing a negativity to you that you want to block or you don't really want to take in, how do we handle those people, especially people that we have to deal with?
Yeah. I've got a twofold answer for you. The first part, one of the people that I follow who I really like is Abraham Hicks. And I remember somebody once asking Abraham Hicks, how do you get rid of doubt? And the answer was, before it happens. And so the first part of the question that I would give to you on this, and I'll bet you could say this about juicing too and about food, how do you deal with negative people, or how do you deal with negativity before it happens? So what does that mean? Well, that means if you are feeling good, feeling positive, fired up, thinking about life in such a good way, so happy, and you go into a local convenience store and the clerk is rude, you don't even notice that they're rude because you're like so into your own world, they don't even come on your radar. So self-care, staying centered, having the intention takes care of most of it. Now, let's say you have an opportunity where you do run into somebody negative or something negative happens. Most people want to make it about that person. And what we recommend is, again, a couple of fold attack on this, for lack of a better word. What would be a better word than attack? A couple of fold plan. So the first part is, if somebody's coming on my radar that's negative and I'm noticing they're negative, I must not be on my center as much as I thought I was. So that's the first thing. Become aware of, like, okay, here I am in this situation. This person is really getting on my nerves. Maybe I need a nap. Maybe I need something to eat. Maybe I'm, not taking care of myself as well. Maybe I need a little break. Maybe I'm overtired. Whatever it is, it's about me that I even notice that they're off center. Then secondly, if you continually have somebody in your life that's off center, we have a saying that is called, the problem is not the problem. The problem is that I keep thinking about the problem and I keep talking about the problem. So the problem isn't that you aren't healthy. The problem is that you continually talk about not being healthy and think about not being healthy. So the problem isn't that your partner is negative. The problem is that you keep talking about them being negative or thinking about them being negative. So what happens is the reticular activating system says, oh, I got it. Your partner's negative. That's important to you. Don't worry. We're on it. We're going to notice every time they're negative, just like we notice the green pickup truck you've been looking for or the pregnant woman. The reticular activating system is always looking for whatever you're thinking about and talking about. So if you're talking about how negative your mother is, your reticular activating system says, yeah, we'll make sure and notice every time she's negative. So if you want to change the people around you, then you have to start seeing them and expecting them to be a different way. It has to start with you having a different expectation of them. And frankly, when you hear it that way, don't you want to bring out the best in people? Don't you want to see the best in them? Don't you want to connect with them at their highest selves? You know, your mother or your father or your friend or whoever it is may still end up being not very nice to other people or being crabby or being negative, but around you, you will only see them at their highest self. You will train your brain that this is what I expect from them. Does that make sense, Steve?
I love that. Yeah, it's brilliant.
Really long answer for, but you think you get where I'm going with it.
It's brilliant. Thank you. And so you talk about affirmations and mantras, and are they the same? And can you give us an example of how we can start using these for more vitality, for more wealth, for a better life?
Okay, so affirmations and mantras are basically at the core the same thing. Same with declarations or incantations, any word like that you've heard. What it is it's a short, positive phrase that makes you feel good when you say it. Okay, so in the past with affirmations, most of the time people would tell you more specific is better. You would get these stories like, you know, I'm on stage wearing my red dress, accepting the award for, you know, and we try to make them really specific. But what happens is your brain starts calling BS on you when you get really specific. It starts going, come on, the red dress, you haven't fit into that red dress in such a long time. Like, you start debating it. So what we find is that if you use an affirmation, if you can be specific, that's awesome, but better to feel good. So you're much better off with a mantra that sounds like, things are getting better and better. I'm doing better and better all the time. I'm getting better and better at juicing all the time. You know, in every way, every day and every way, I'm getting better and better, right? So you're better off using little phrases that are just kind of vague and fun, because they're only designed to make you feel good, but they end up matching up too. You end up matching up your brain. So with health ones, there's so many good ones you can say. Like, I love my body loves me, I know what to do, I trust my body, my body's feeling better every day, I'm on my way to better and better health, I love my positive health habits that I'm developing, I'm moving in the direction of better health all the time. I mean, when you pick one of those, imagine how good it feels to say 50 times a day, I'm moving in the direction of better health.
Well, I'll tell you, like, I remember when I was getting into shape, when I was trying, because I was overweight by the time I got out of college, I couldn't even look at myself in the mirror. It was horrible. But what would we focus on? I mean, I just remember clearly what it was like to focus on the parts that you hated, you know, and just kind of look in the mirror and just zoom in on, and then you're working out and you see it's still there and you feel like you're a failure. So I think that's what a lot of people might go through.
Yeah, exactly. And it's our tendency. We want to do that. We want to hone in on the one thing that's wrong and try to fix it, try to wrestle it to the ground and fix it. But if you could just instead pay attention to the 90% that's going right, you'd get much more traction, because it goes back to that emotion. When you're feeling good, you're unstoppable. When you're feeling good, you're in the flow. When you're feeling good, you know, when you have negative emotion, you're closing the creative pathways of your brain. When you have positive emotion, you open up the creative pathways. You get good ideas. You feel like engaging. You like people better. They like you better. You're bringing the best you to the table. I mean, when you feel good, stuff just seems to happen and you feel like you get in the flow. And the best part is you can feel good intentionally by intentionally making a choice to think better thoughts. So this isn't hard. This isn't like I have to wait 3 weeks to feel good. You can feel better in 3 minutes. If you just give yourself a chance, you can do it right now. As soon as you're done listening to this interview, just start saying a few nice sentences to yourself and feel the effect on your body.
Love it. And that would be the example. Like let's share, what was your mantra this morning?
Oh gosh, you know, I always have a variety of different mantras going, but right now I've been using one word phrases. And my word that I've been saying over and over all the time is clarity, 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 clarity. And then, you know, I build on that and you can go in a bunch of different directions. I'm getting more clarity. I love this clarity. I'm more and more clarity, all the time more clarity, like just on and on and on, letting it build. And that's like, my buzzword right now is clarity. I'm just feeling so, so good about life.
And my new one is simplicity.
Oh, yes, that's a good one too. I love it.
So, Dani, you know I love your work. How can our listeners start following what you're doing today and get involved in this?
You know, the best way is just to go to danawild.com and you'll see a bunch of things that you can sign up for if you want to, like mantras of the day or trainings or sandboxes that we've got going out there to play in. So danawild.com is the best bet.
Right. And we'll put a link right under your show notes here for this interview. And anything else we can share with our viewers about how we can start, you know, changing our mindset, staying with the mindset, making this a habit, making our habits stick?
Yes, I do. Especially with taking on new health habits, focus on what's going right. So you're going to make mistakes. You're going to do stuff wrong every day when it comes to your health, without a shadow of a doubt, just like we do things wrong in all sorts of areas. But focus on what's going right, no matter what it is. That if you think only about what's going right, you're going to get more and more and more of what's going right. So just if one little setback, ignore it completely and focus on what's going right. And that's it. And then that's the ticket.
I love it. Thank you. Dana Wild, you're a rock star. Thank you so much. You know, we love you. And thank you for being part of our Vitality World Summit and all the work you're doing.
Right back at you, Steve. I enjoy you so much and I love what you're doing. And I'm so happy to be part of the journey with you. Like, I'm juicing every day because of you. So thank you so much for that.
That's the rock star, Dana Wild. I'm Steve Prusak, and we'll see you in the next session.